Can everybody hear me? Yes? All right. Great. So, hello. Welcome, everybody, to Troop 254's Eagle Court of Honor. My name is Miles. I'll be your master of ceremonies for tonight. So, please take a seat, those of you who have not taken a seat yet, as our ceremony is going to begin. And that looks like most of everybody. So, I would like to invite all of our adult leaders to join me on the stage if they are present. All of our adult leaders, there we go. Okay. Yes. Higher, great. I guess everybody couldn't hear me. Okay, so everybody please stand for the presentation of the colors. Okay. Color guard, parade the colors.
Four, parade. Mark.
Skyline salute. Yeah. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Two. Skyline sign. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country and to obey the Scout law, to help other people at all times, keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. Two. Scout and sign again. A scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. Two. Color guard, post the colors. The audience may be seated. Thank you very much. So, I'd like to invite Pastor Ming to say a prayer for our ceremony. Thanks.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to come together as family, friends, and leaders and scouts on this significant day in honoring Andy, Brendan, Christopher, Jacob, and Nathan. Lord, today is a celebration of the journey that was full of challenges, friendships, and struggles. We thank you, Lord, for all of the merit badges that were earned along the way, the oaths that were committed between these young men. Heavenly Father, we thank you for just the months and the years of their faithfulness and also the faithfulness of the uncles who helped them along the way. We ask, Lord, for your blessing on these gentlemen. We ask for your blessings on their families who supported them and encouraged them. We pray also, Lord, for the fellow scouts who are following behind them. Heavenly Father, may you continue to place your spirit on Troop 254. May you help them to continue to be physically fit and morally straight. In your son's name we pray. Amen.
Okay. So, first thing, I would like to invite Jalen to introduce this Court of Honors Eagle Scouts.
Hello, everyone. I'm here to introduce the Eagle Scouts. If they could join me on the stage as I call their names, that would be wonderful. Andy Z, Brandon Lee, Christopher Liu, Jacob Wong, and Nathan Lee.
I'll be right behind you.
Now, I'd like to have any other Eagle Scouts in the room to please stand up where you are and say your name in the year you received Eagle rank. After you say these things, please stay standing. Can you please start?
Okay. Let's have one more round of applause for all of our Eagle Scouts in the room. Thank you very much. You are dismissed. Back to your seats. Thank you. All right. Next up, I would like to invite Nathaniel to give us a brief history of the Boy Scouting program and what it means to be an Eagle Scout. Thank you, Nathaniel.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. I'm here to talk about the brief history of scouting. In 1908, retired Lieutenant General Robert Baden Powell founded the Scout Association in Britain. The program was founded on the ideal of instilling leadership and discipline into boys to help them become Britain's finest. He modeled the association on the structure of the British Army, which he had served in and drew his inspiration from. In 1910, Baden Powell and his friends decided to bring the Scout Association to the United States of America. The program was a success and was soon known as the Boy Scouts of America. The program grew fast and enjoyed much popularity throughout the years. Due to the structure of the scouting program, a scout system, a rank system was devised to distinguish the scouts. The original badge was the Silver Wolf badge, based off the British system. However, American boards decided that the highest badge was to be the American Eagle. So the Eagle badge was devised and awarded for the first time in 1912. Since that time, the Eagle Scout badge has been associated with moral excellence and accomplishment. The Eagle badge even has its own association with members in all degrees of success throughout the professional world. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Nathaniel, again. So, I would like to invite Climb up. This is our third and last scout to come up to talk about the climb to Eagle rank and what that means. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm here to talk about how these Eagle Scouts became to where they are. Well, the Eagle Scout, obviously. In the beginning, when a scout joins, they receive a scout uniform and a book. The scout book contains information for scouts to complete achievements and requirements to climb the ranks. There are six ranks leading to Eagle, which is Scout, Tenderfoot, Second Class, First Class, Star, and Life. I will individually explain what these Eagle Scouts did to achieve their Eagle. First, the Scout rank. Scouts will learn the basics of scouting and able to recite and memorize the scout oath, law, motto, slogan, sign, handshake, and salute. The second rank is Tenderfoot. Well, scouts will get hand-on experiences with knot tying, cooking, and color guard. Third, the second class rank. The second class rank is a little bit more advanced than the previous two. Scouts will be able to sharpen and care for certain tools, light campfires, and have the ability to treat first aid. The fourth rank is first class, which is an advanced rank where scouts will improve and improve their skills in their previous ranks. The fifth rank is star. Star is when a scout is trying to earn all 21 merit badges and continue with leadership positions. The sixth rank is life. The life rank encourages scouts to continue earning merit badges and advance skill and position. And finally, the seventh rank, which is eagle. An eagle requires a scout to plan and complete an Eagle Scout project that benefits to the community and must earn 24 merit badges minimum and 13 of those 21 merit badges must be Eagle required. And that's all. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you, Klein, for that very detailed explanation. Next, I'm going to be inviting Uncle Tim to come up and say some things.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. Yeah, I just appreciate you guys coming out to recognize the five scouts today that are getting their Eagle Scout. Just like to mention, this court of honor was all planned by the scouts this afternoon, so let's give them a hand. And also, the reception later on this evening was planned by many hard work of their families, so let's give them a hand ahead of time. I have the honor of introducing our guest speakers. The first one is no stranger to you. He was the former governor of our wonderful state of Washington and the United States ambassador to China. But most of all, most importantly, he was a member of Troop 254. Would you guys welcome me, please, to the stage, the Honorable Kerry Locke.
Thank you very much, Tim, for the introduction. It's really a pleasure to be here and to see a lot of old friends. I see Roland Wong, he stood up. I did not stand up, but maybe because of my age, I didn't quite hear what we were supposed to do. But Roland and I were in Troop 254 together many, 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 many years ago. And I guess you got your Eagle in 1966. I got mine in 1964. And Troop 254 is one of the oldest continuously chartered troops in the Chief Seattle Council area. Let me just say that it's great to see so many adult leaders who are part of Troop 254. I think when Roland and I were in Scouts, we only had about maybe three or four adults at the time. And Scouting meant the world to me. A lot of us at that time, in the late 50s, early 60s, were children, sons of immigrants. And our moms and dads worked in restaurants, in the garment factories, worked in grocery stores. And because they were working normally 7 days a week, 12, 14 hours a day, we didn't have that many parents who could take us on hiking trips. And sometimes our campouts were actually canceled because we couldn't get enough dads to join. And to see so many adults that are here as part of 254 is incredible. And I want to thank you for your leadership and your commitment to the young boys and now the girls that will be able to be part of the scouting movement. For me, I think my parents pushed me into scouting. I wasn't quite on the right track and maybe getting into the influence of some bad people in the neighborhood. And so they heard of some they had family friends whose sons were in the Boy Scouts in 254, and so they pushed me to join. And I have to say that the scout leaders really became almost like surrogate families. Not just surrogate dads, but the moms became like surrogate aunts. I really benefited so much from the scouting movement. It kept me on the straight and narrow, and so many of the values and the skills that I learned in scouting all the way, not just through Eagle, but beyond Eagle, have continued to serve me to this day. So the scouting program not only teaches boys and girls now skills, but values, determination, hard work, dedication, and perseverance. So to all the scouts here, I think we should be giving all of our parents and the adult leaders a big round of applause for what they do for us. It's amazing that we have five that we're honoring today as Eagle Scouts. The journey to Eagle is not easy at all. I mean, we had a presentation about all the different steps, tenderfoot, second class, first class, star, life, and Eagle, but it's actually very, very hard. A small percentage of boys and now girls are involved in the scouting movement. An even smaller percentage ever become Eagle. But for those who are part of that Eagle honor, it is a lifelong achievement, and you are in the company of some great Americans, people who are astronauts, people who become president of the United States of America, leaders of major corporations, actors and actresses and movie stars and everything else. I mean, people who are really skilled in the arts, in dance, performance, business, finance, academia, politics. So you're joining a very select group of people. Say that you are an Eagle, and people have higher expectations of you because they know the journey that you have gone through. Put down on your resume that you are an Eagle, and it also gives you instant recognition and perhaps increased stature. So be proud in all of the work that you do or in your future life to say that you are an Eagle. But know that when people find out that you're an Eagle, they have higher expectations of you, and rightly so. I want to say to the Eagles here, stay active in scouting. This is not the end of your journey, but really a major milestone, but also the opening of doors that will lead to even greater adventures and greater opportunities. I very much stayed active in scouting after becoming an Eagle. I became very active in the Order of the Arrow, became chapter chief, and then was very active in the Tecopi Kwisquis Lodge, which is the greater Seattle area. But also I went on to become a counselor at a Boy Scout camp, Camp Omanche, which is now called Camp Pigot. At that time, when Roland and I were going to Camp Omanche, we had to cook our own food. Camp Parsons, of course, on Hood Canal is a dining hall operation, and it's one of the oldest ones in the United States. And we've had many governors and others who have served as staff members at Camp Parsons. But Camp Parsons was on Hood Canal, and that's very, very cold and very hard to learn how to swim. And as you know, to be a first-class scout, you have to swim so many yards, and to be an Eagle, you have to get your swimming merit badge and your life-saving merit badge. So in order to really learn how to swim and to become a first-class scout, I joined the YMCA, but I didn't like going to Camp Parsons. Camp Omanche, on the other hand, was a great, great camp. But you had to cook your own food. When I became a counselor there, certain counselors, certain staff members were assigned to different troops. And unfortunately, I was always assigned to the troops that were always in trouble and had difficulty, who had maybe weak adult leadership or brand new troops who really didn't have many skills. So I had to eat the food cooked by these scouts. And I chipped a lot of teeth. I lost a lot of weight. I got sick oftentimes. And sometimes on certain days when we knew that they had to cook a certain meal, we knew that they couldn't cook that meal on time before camp resumed, because the camp would break at 5 o'clock, dinner's at 6 o'clock, camp would resume at 7 o'clock. And one of the major dishes was Omanche stew. A lot of the scouts in these troops that I worked with did not really know how to build a fire. If they built a fire, it was too small. And they had to boil water to cook the potatoes. They would only cut the potatoes into either half or quarters, which took forever to get softened. And if you have a huge kettle of water, that would take forever for that kettle of water to boil, and you didn't need that much water. So trying to help the scouts cook stew was important if I wanted to eat. And oftentimes I did not get a chance to eat because camp would have to resume at 7. I'd run down to the lodge and I'd grab a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, or we'd eat up at lunch. Lunch and breakfast, the staff ate among ourselves. So that day at lunch, we made sure that we ate a big meal, knowing that we probably would not have dinner. But I also learned a lot as a counselor. I learned that I could not just tell the scouts, that's a crummy fire, or you have way too much water, or why are you cutting the potatoes only into quarters or halves? You should really try to dice them up into really small chunks so that they'll cook faster. Because scouts, young scouts, have very fragile egos. They look up to those camp counselors. And if you really jump on them and criticize them, it really hurts their feelings and will demoralize them. So I had to learn at a very early age, when I was a camp counselor, how to be very tactful. That's a great fire, guys, but here's some ideas on how we can make it bigger. Hey, I'm really glad that you cut up those potatoes, but here's a tip. If you cut them up maybe a little bit smaller, maybe they'll cook faster, and you guys will be able to eat, and then you can resume your activities at 7 o'clock. Or, hey, I like the way in which you've built the fire and the potatoes are great. Hey, maybe you don't need quite as much water, but think about it. It's up to you guys. And so really trying to learn tact and trying to encourage people and how to point out useful ideas is something that I learned in scouting, and that has really served me well all through the years. So be active in scouting. Stay active in scouting, because those young kids that are coming up as scouts, as tenderfoot, they're going to look up to you. I remember looking up to the Eagles in our Troop 254 and how much awe that I had for them, and what a role model they were for me. You don't have to be a camp counselor, but you can have great influence on the young scouts as they learn how to sharpen a knife or an axe or how to build a fire. Share the knowledge and the wisdom that you have gained, and not just for the young scouts, but all the people that you will encounter throughout your life. You have done a lot in terms of your community service projects, and many people will benefit from that. But more than anything, you've learned skills, you've learned leadership, you've learned camaraderie, and you've learned patience, perseverance, and dedication. You've shown that when times are tough, you can overcome and you can succeed. These are the lessons of life that will stay with you forever. Keep them close to you, remember them, share them with others, and may your journey throughout the rest of your life be as great as it has been these last few years. Congratulations to all of you, and thank you very much.
Thank you for those encouraging words. Our next guest speaker is Corey Carlson, and Mr. Carlson is our Thunderbird District Eagle Advancement Chairman. So he is almost like the final step in these five guys and future Eagle Scouts to achieving their rank. And we go through a very intense border review, one last step. So let's invite Mr. Corey Carlson up here to speak for us.
This is the original Scout Handbook. It's actually the 25th edition of the first Scout Handbook. And this is, when I grabbed it, I thought was the most recent Scout Handbook, but there's one more after that. Now, this is where most of you started, and then we kind of changed it during the process. This is the 12th edition. So there's now a 13th edition, or maybe they call it the 14th skip, I don't know. But if you compare these books, you'll find a huge, huge amount of similarity, and you'll find some glaring differences. For example, we don't have a pathfinding merit badge any longer because we have GPSs. We don't do birding any longer, and I'm not certain why, but I can tell you that when Phil Smart spoke, he explained he would always talk about learning the names of 31 birds and how much he hated that. So maybe it's Phil Smart that changed that one, I'm not certain. But this book was 110 years ago that it started. So in 1910 is when this book was first published. And when this book was published, it was the second best-selling book in America. Do you know what the first was? The Bible. That's pretty remarkable to be the second best-selling book in America for a number of years. In the Bible, it says there's a passage that you all know. It's my favorite. When Christ is asked, "What do I need to know to get to heaven?" And he said, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself." Only these two are what's necessary. I love it when churches sponsor scouting because it's the match that belongs together. The church focuses on loving our Lord and loving our neighbor. Scouting focuses on loving our neighbor and loving our Lord. It's the same coin. We just focus on one side a little more. And I want to explain to you how. And it's a lot of the terminology that we use. The first thing is the Scout slogan. Does anybody want to say what the Scout slogan is? I'll help. You know it. Do a good turn daily. It's a very simple. But if we all did that, think of how different the world would be. We all just said, and that may be as simple as helping someone with their groceries to the car, or as major as saving the life of someone out on the water. And Scouts have done both. The Scout motto, be prepared. Again, it's very simple. And how do Scouts work to make you prepared? As the very good description of the seven ranks we go through, is you learn how to cook. sometimes making a lot of mess along the way, but you do learn. And in fact, one of the things I have to tell you, in this book, cooking is a required merit badge. In this book, it's not. So in the 13th, they brought it back again. Big mistake as far as I'm concerned. It should have been there the whole time. And someone asked Lord Baden-Powell, who's the founder of Scouting, he said, "What do you want me to be prepared for?" And he looked at him and he said, "For everything." And that's what Scouting wants you to be prepared for. And that was the skill set in those 7 steps that we tried to take the boys through. And by the 7th, the boys were leading the others and getting there themselves. What's the Scout Oath? I want to go through this because this is long. On my honor, to do my duty to God and my country. Going back to that original phraseology in the Bible, it's God and our friends, it's God and our country. To obey the Scout Law, which I'm going to come to in a moment. To help other people at all times. Again, to help other people at all times. To do a good turn daily, to be prepared. It's the same theme over and over and over again. To keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. So the Scout Law we refer to. There's 12 parts of the Scout Law. You heard it earlier, but I want to repeat them again slowly. A Scout is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent. It's back. Reverent is back. But in there too, my favorite one is the simplest one, I think, is be kind. Trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind. Just be kind. And it's a big step. And we live in a world right now where kindness is a pretty important skill. That you heard there were 7 ranks. There's 21 merit badges. 13 of those merit badges are required. Cooking got brought back in. Birding is out. Pathfinding is out. GPSs are in. And girls are in. So Scouting is moving to including women in the program, which I personally think is wonderful for the men. I think that the skills that they'll bring will be fabulous for Scouting, and we'll learn how to bring that together. I do want to tell one story. Dan Evans, so I was a Scoutmaster at Troop 15. Troop 15 is out of Epiphany Parish. I will say I have a bit of a bias. I like the troops that come out of the churches because of, you know, to love the Lord your God and to love your neighbors yourself. Those are the two most important commandments. But Dan Evans, when Dan was a senator, had an opportunity to meet with the then president. Actually, Gary, you would know that. Was he the governor when he met with Gerald Ford? Was he senator at that time, or would he have been a governor?
He was senator.
Okay. He had an opportunity. Dan Evans, Eagle Scout. Gerald Ford, Eagle Scout. He had an opportunity to meet because he was trying to explain to him to turn the enchantments here in the state of Washington into a national monument. The president had been busy. The meeting was running over. He was scheduled for 10 minutes. He was brought in 5 minutes late. The president works on a very tight schedule. He was told that by every secretary and every representative as he walked through the halls to get to the president's office. He got in there and he said, "Mr. President, I would like to encourage you to make the enchantments a national monument." And he said, "Okay, let's look at it." He looked at it. He started reminiscing about the trips he'd taken in Michigan. He was there for 2 hours. The staff was furious. But we now have the enchantments as a national monument. Now, whether you gentlemen are governors, or if you gentlemen are businessmen, or you gentlemen are scientists, or you gentlemen are whatever you choose to be, it's because of what you do here, the hard work you put into being a scout, that I have the greatest faith in your success and the fact that you will do a good turn every day. God bless you. Thank you.
All right. Thank you again for speaking. So we'll get right to it. Next we have our presentation of the awards. So where is that? Sorry. Not there. Yes, okay. So inviting up the Eagle Scouts that we had up earlier. Please come up. Enough script bolts. Sounds great. Okay, so we have this strapping young lad here. will Andy's parents please come up? Okay. All right. So, just as a note for all of the other parents out there, the mother of this family will be pinning the award onto the uniform. So, with a little help from our friends. Okay, it's up now. Can we get a round of applause for Andy? Congratulations. All right. Next, can we get Brandon to come up?
Thank you.
All right. And will Brandon's parents please join me on stage? And Brandon. Round of applause for Brandon. Congratulations. Thank you. Thank you very much. All Chris, come up. All right. And Chris's people.
Hi.
Get your familiars. Yeah. And round of applause for Chris. Congratulations also. Yeah. Congrats. All right. Jacob, come up. Yeah. You heard that. That's camaraderie right there. All right. Jacob's family, join us up on stage. Congratulations. Thank you. Okay. Next up, Nathan. Nathan, please come up. Nice. Congrats. All right. And Nathan's family, join us up on stage. Very good. All right. Oh. All right. Congratulations. Thank you. Okay. So, Andy, come up here. Are you responding as an Eagle Scout? Is that what you're doing?
Yeah.
Sounds great. Do that.
My name is Andy. I like to thank God first because I'm really fortunate to grow up in Chinese Baptist Church. And my parents are from China, so I was really fortunate to come to a troop here where it's Chinese leaders and mostly Chinese Scouts. So it really helped me fit in and help me grow. Like the Honorable Gary Locke said, a lot of us younger scouts, when we first start out, we look up to our older scouts. And I still remember them because they taught us how to build a fire in the pouring rain. And especially special because who would have thought that was possible? And it was Gary Wong who taught us, and we still talk about him as the firebender. So now, like, if you can't start a fire, we just use hand sanitizer. I encourage all the scouts to go to every trip, because every trip, it helps develop a different part of your character. Going to Igloo, it really tests your resilience and your ability to come back next year and try it again. Because the first time that you go to Igloo, you go up to Mount Rainier and spend a night there, and you're skinny and only 11 years old. So a lot of people have get really close to hypothermia. So you have to be really resilient to go to another trip like that. For fishing, it teaches you patience, and that's really important later on in life. And then backpacking, I want to acknowledge Uncle Marvin, because he really teaches us how to use a map and compass, how to plan, and most especially, he knows all the trees. So, it inspired me to go to college and also learn about trees. Thank you for that. And also Uncle Tim for having a steady schedule for us. We always have the same trips year in and year out, because we have a steady program, and it's always Uncle Tim that keeps it going. I thank him for that. Summer camp, it brings out the best in the scouts. So if you have a time to go to summer camp, you should go, because we always try to get bring the best out of every scout. We always try to get number one in the relays, in the in everything. So when we were younger and we weren't gonna get number one because a Japanese troop was gonna beat us, we prayed that it was gonna storm and rain. And it did. It was canceled, so we never took a loss. Yeah. And my time at Scouts is really special, because we got to bring the Scouts down to Oregon for Camp Meriwether. We haven't gone back for a while. And we also been to Yellowstone, and that's incredible. Because I never heard of anybody going to Yellowstone from our troop. Thanks to all the uncles. And what I like to say is, for the younger scouts, we give you push-ups because we like to discipline you and get you stronger. And a lot of people, I felt like maybe wanting to quit because it was too hard, but that also gives you resilience, us giving you push-ups. So makes you stronger. So whether it's biking and you have to have a lot of endurance, or backpacking where you have to be prepared for anything, we also always carry our scout law and scout oath with us. And because we memorize it since getting our scout rank, which is the very first rank of Boy Scouts, we're able to keep referring to that over and over again. But one of the verses from the Bible that I always like to help me is that the Lord says that do not fear or be afraid of them, because or terrified because of them, for the Lord your God will always be with you wherever you go. And that helped me going to Camp Parsons. The water was really cold, and I had to do life-saving merit badge. So the way I prepared for that was, the water's really cold, swimming test. I took cold showers every day to prepare for that, and took more swim lessons. So yeah, it's all about never giving up. And if you never give up, you're going to be like all of us here. all of us here, we basically got our Eagle Scouts when we were like 18. So, except for Christopher. So, just don't give up. All the way up to the last minute. Dedication is hard work and patience. So, thank you very much, and the marathon continues.
Thank you, Andy, for that very long speech. Next, I would like to invite Brandon to make a short statement. Shorter statement. Thank you.
Okay, so for those of you that don't know me, my name is Brandon Lee, and I've been affiliated with this troop for about 8 years. The one thing that I'd say this troop has really taught me is it's just how to be a man, you know? In this troop, you get to learn how to admit your own mistakes. And, you know, even as like a younger scout, I specifically remember because some of the older guys when I first joined are in this room right now. But when I joined, I was pretty much like the weird little scout that played in the corner with the building blocks and Legos. And really, most of these older guys, even though I, at that time, I thought were mean, I mean, they were just trying to get me to come out of my shell, really, and they were really encouraging me to try, really. And that's something that I want all of you younger scouts to remember, is even though all these scouts, these older guys might yell at you and just say some really mean things. I just want to say, don't give up, because in the end, it's all worth it. And you know, that's not a message for just the younger scouts either, even you older scouts. This program really teaches you how to lead people. And I really think that'll take you far, just that alone. Yeah, that's pretty much all I wanted to say. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Brandon. Next, will Chris come up to the stage and make another short statement?
So I'm gonna try and keep this a little short. First off, on my road to Eagle, I'd just like to thank my parents for getting me into the program. I mean, I never actually really thought about it until they dragged me into the room one day and said, hey, you're gonna be here for the next couple hours. So I just said, you know, that's okay. Guess I'll see what it's all about. And as you can probably see, I enjoyed it. So the people behind me, all the adult leaders are really the key to my success. When I started, I didn't really understand like the full leadership thing, and they're just kind of like, well, you get to lead the kids now. But that didn't really ring with me because I had no idea how to do it. But I mean, over the years, as I grew with the program, and of course going on all the outings and just learning those little life lessons that they all tell you, they really helped shape me into who I am today. I mean, like Andy said, you know, going on that igloo trip, right? There's that fine line between the people who make it and the people who like kind of scrape by. But to be honest, that was my first trip and I barely made it. So, I mean, pulling through with hypothermia and everything and still going back, that's kind of like the thing. You go back for fun and to learn and what you can improve on. And that's one of the things that I'd like to highlight to the younger scouts. Like, no matter how far you go with it, and if you make Eagle eventually, you can't just sit down and say, you know, I'm done learning. There's always more for you to learn. And be it self-improvement and eventually getting around to giving back to the other scouts, that's what you need to work on and think about, because that's what's going to get you far. So, I mean, once again, thanks to all the adults behind me who really helped to push me into this, and to my parents too. So thank everybody else for being here and just showing the support to the troop.
Great. Okay. And will Jacob come up and make another statement?
Hi, I'm Jacob Wong. Can read that up there. So I have so many things written down, and I've forgotten all of them, even though they're literally right in front of me. So I joined Scouts because I have three brothers, two of which are older than me, that both got into Boy Scouts. I can't remember if one was the Eagle Scout already by the time I joined, but I had a lot of pressure because there was just so high of an expectation for me to live up to. So for the first year, I was enjoying myself, just having fun as a Boy Scout. The second and third and fourth and fifth, I really didn't feel like I could do or get Eagle because I just felt so far behind with everything. Uncle Daryl, you can wave. Yeah, it's his fault. Because he told me when I was 13, I want you to get Eagle by 15. So I proceeded to not do that and get it at 18. So, yeah. This being a Boy Scout has really provided a lot of like special opportunities because I don't think your average kid gets to go on a trip to Yellowstone with like all of these bros with him that he's been able to hang out with once a week for a couple hours for the past like 5-6 years of his life, and just seeing life as a highway for 20 minutes as loud as you can. And just scouting has been such a pleasure to be in. It's taught me a lot of things with being prepared. Again, being prepared in everything that we do. We were planning this Court of Honor for a month, probably. I've been working on it for the past 2 weeks every single day and just hoping for the best. And it seems that it's gone pretty well so far. But yeah, so scouting is just, it's a lot more than just making fires and playing with knives and camping and stuff. It's really just like, it's an experience to help teach these young men, these boys, how to become men and be able to raise families of their own or just become good people later in life. So yeah, that's about it.
All right. Thank you, Jacob. And lastly, I would like to invite Nathan up to make our last statement.
Hello, my name is Nathan, and I really enjoyed scouting. I joined when in 2012, I think, and at first I wasn't really sure of it. I didn't know anybody, but all the adult leaders and all the scouts that were there at the time really helped me to get used to it, as well as be able to enjoy my time here. And it's really a privilege to be in Scouts, because it's your average kid doesn't get to go out every month and do go camping for a weekend, nor do they get to come hang out with a whole bunch of other boys. Usually typical kids would just sit in their rooms on their computers or something. So yeah, I really enjoyed it, especially since I'm into like biking. So I really enjoyed the biking trips that we had, and despite the low endurance I have, but I pushed through. And it's the one thing I would say to the younger scouts is that go do the hard work, and in the end, your hard work will be rewarded with fun stuff that you get to do in the troop, like the go-karting that you guys did on your climbing trip that I'm sure you guys enjoyed, which I sure did too. And Funny enough, even though they didn't drift, I tried drifting in the cars, which was didn't turn out so well. And yeah, I think that's it.
All right, I'm just gonna move this up. So thank you to Nathan for that. Now we have a short little slideshow prepared by Jacob, all that hard work of all of these scouts' experiences over the past, what did you say, 8 years or so, something like that. So please enjoy that. Thank you. And I would like to dismiss our adult leaders from the stage.
As a child, you would wait and watch from far away, but you always knew that you'd be the one to work while they all play. And you lay awake at night and scheme of all the things that you would change, but it was just a dream. I have
through my darkest of dreams. Be the power to compel me, hold me closer than anyone before. Set me free.
Thanks again to Jacob for producing that slideshow. It was very entertaining. Next, I would like to invite Uncle Daryl, who would like to say a few words to our scouts, up to the stage. So, pass it off.
Yeah. Hey, it's a little bit hot here. Hey, thank you. And thank you all for coming to celebrate these five boys and their Eagle accomplishment here. I just want to say how proud I am of each one of you guys, and that you made your Eagle. A little earlier this evening, one of the adult leaders asked me, hey, didn't you get your Eagle? I said, no, I'm atoning for my sins. I have a life sentence now of being an adult leader to make sure you guys all get your Eagle. So this is my sentence. I'm for you guys, okay? Anyway, I'm gonna miss you. I'm going to miss seeing you guys on every Tuesday. I'm glad that Brandon has been able to have time to come back and volunteer as an adult leader, as some of the other kids have been able to come back. And that is a wonderful testament to our troop. Tim and I and Marvin grew up in this troop, and we're starting to see our seventh generation of kids come through here now. And it's just amazing to watch each and every one of you grow. And for you new kids that are coming up, I am so looking forward to seeing what you guys do. Keep me laughing and entertained. I want to see all your quirky things happening. Jacob and Chris would always just ask me quirky questions or tell me things that are just happening in their life, or the latest video game or something, and just make me laugh. Brandon, you are amazing. You told me how important Scouts was for you, and that you did not want to leave this troop. You would rather quit football than Scouts. Andy, I love it. And you're asking me advice that you needed and that sort of thing, and hopefully I've been able to steer you right. Nathan, it's been great watching you grow. Your leadership skills, your confidence has just grown. It's just amazing. And what Uncle Corey and Uncle Gary said, take it to heart. Your future is bright, and there's going to be so many doors and opportunities opening up to you guys. And even the rest of you, as you've seen, these five guys have been your role models now. And so I know they'll come back to visit from time to time. I'm going to cherish all the memories I've had. Jacob, when you first started, and I felt like I took you under my wing when you got popped in the eye with the softball, you know? And I was like, whoa. And even your brother, when he first came in, and he got heat stroke when we went up Mount Si. So I've got to take care of you and your brother. Yeah, and so little brother Jeremy is going to have the pressure on him now, and then there'll be hopefully four Eagles in your family. And so anyway, I look forward to, if you have more advice you need, our one-on-one talks about life, your happiness, your sadnesses, your challenges, like other alumni scout. I've been honored to help write recommendation letters for them throughout the years. They put me on their resume as references and that sort of thing. I'm more than happy. I'll look forward to that for you guys. Andy, I'll look forward to more photography questions from you as well. So anyway, just one more round of applause for these guys and their great accomplishment.
Thank you, Uncle Daryl. I wish people would say things like that about me more often. But next. Yeah. So I would like to invite Pastor Mike up to close our ceremony today. So thank you.
All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for these wonderful young men. And we would just like to pray a blessing over them. Lord, would you help them first and foremost to find their identity in your Son, Jesus Christ. And Lord, would you be gracious to help them to grow in wisdom and in stature. Would you use them to stand for justice and righteousness? Would you help them to be strong yet gentle? Would you help them to positively influence this culture and this society? Help them, Lord, to stay pure before your eyes. Would you help them to stay on the straight path and press forward to all that you have called them to be? Would you help them to flourish in all that they do? Help them to live for something greater than themselves, to live for the one and true living God. Would you shower your favor upon them? Would you bless them? Would you protect them? Would you guide them for the rest of their lives? We thank you for this precious time of celebration where we gather to celebrate the achievement of these young men. We thank you for all the adult volunteers and counselors and people of this church and outside of this church who have poured a piece of their life to benefit these young men. Would you use them in a mighty way? We thank you for this time. In the precious name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Okay, I know before we dismiss for that delicious dinner the family has prepared for us, I have one more honored guest, Kimberly Canoose. She is our Thunderbird District Executive. And she works down at the scout office, and she represents our troop. And please welcome her up as she presents the Friends of Scouting presentation. Kim.
Thank you. Wow, this was fantastic. First of all, I love this hall. It's just, I love the light coming down. It's so beautiful. I am here to present Friends of Scouting, which is an annual fundraiser that we do in our council to support our council. And what the boys are going to hand out are some pens and some flyers that you can fill in. We'll just take a couple of moments at the end of this to fill those out. Why we do fundraising is because it is a big chunk of what runs our council, being able to have the four camps that we have. I've been able to go to some trainings nationally, and there are some councils that their only camp is a field. And I mean, not even a place to build a fire. I'm not saying they don't build fires, but they don't have Camp Parsons, they don't have Piggott, they don't have Edward, and they don't have Shepherd. Why do I give to scouting? Because of this. I mean, this presentation that we have a chance to get boys and now girls to Eagle. And all of the things that Corey and Governor Locke said are so true. Why I love scouting so much is because of the resilience that it builds in not just the kids or the youth or the scouts, but the families. Because families get to participate. And I think the thing that I say the most when I'm out recruiting and talking to people about what scouting is that it teaches us to respond rather than just react. Sometimes we need to react because we put our hand on something hot and we need to pull it away. But we can respond, we can be prepared. And we can say, okay, so it rained on our outing even though it wasn't supposed to, but we can still have a good time. That kind of thing, as all the adults in this room and now scouts also know, is something that will follow you for the rest of your life and make you happy. I love scouting because I smile so much it hurts. Like this presentation was amazing. In light of that, I'm going to have you take a look at what's coming around now as a Friends of Scouting campaign flyer. On the back of it is where the money goes, so that you get to see where your dollars go. 85% of what goes into our fundraising goes right back into program and resources. That's pretty remarkable. We have 18,000 scouts that we serve in our council, and we have about 32 employees. I'm one of them. So again, I'm Kimberly Canals. If you need anything at all, you can contact me directly. If you open up the flyer, you'll see on this last little page is what we're going to collect at the end here. And what we're asking for is for everyone to participate at whatever level makes sense for your family. If you can't participate at this time, because that happens too, please go ahead and just fill out the card and just say not at this time. And that way, when I'm doing follow-up, I'm not going to come back and ask if you received one of these. Different ways of giving. Up at the top, you'll see something called the Summit Circle. That is where you can write down your credit card, and it comes out of your account on a monthly basis. It takes about $180 to put a scout through our program per year. Some of that money also goes to our scout reach programs that we have for Solid Ground. Does anybody need a pen?
Does anyone need a pen?
So it takes about $180. So if you did Summit Circle and you gave $15 a month, a little goes a long way. At the end of the year, that becomes $180. The other way is to do a pledge where we will bill you. And another way is cash or check in a lump sum. So what I'd like to do, first of all, does anybody have any questions about Friends of Scouting, where the money goes, anything? Okay. So I'm going to give you just a couple of moments to fill out the cards, then I'm going to have the boys come around and collect the pens and the cards, and then we're going to have some food. All right? Let's just do like 2 or 3 minutes. It shouldn't take long. And thank you. Okay, we're going to switch it up just a little bit. Why don't we have the gentlemen stand at the door, the scouts stand at the door, and everybody just as you're going out, collect them as you're leaving. Let's do it that way. That way we can go.
Enjoy.
Okay, before we dismiss, the five Eagle Scouts want to stand in the back and greet you. I hear dinner's ready. It's going to be buffet style, so you can talk to the kids as... Yeah, they're going to take pictures later because the family's preparing food, so the families are not available for photos. But why don't we all rise and I'll say grace for us, and we can enjoy and fellowship in the fellowship hall right over there. Okay, bow with me, please. Dear Heavenly Scoutmaster, we just want to thank you again for tonight's ceremony and everybody that's involved. And Lord, we just are so thankful that we get to fellowship and enjoy food now. We ask that you bless the food this evening and in the hands of the many family members that prepared it. And let us have good fellowship in the fellowship hall. We pray all these things in your son's name. Amen.